Welcome to Learn Commerce PU online classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello. Welcome to second PU accountancy online classes. In my previous class, I have solved one problem on interest on drawings. That was withdrawals on different dates with different amounts. We have calculated the product, then applied the formula, arrived at the interest on drawings. Now, next problem I'm going to take up, that is third problem, page number 26, third problem from question bank. Bit different, that is here we can see withdrawals at different, that is quarters. Quarter in the sense a period of 3 months. So there will be 4 quarters in a year, that is accounting year starts from 1st April and ends on 31st March of the next year. So April, May, June will be one quarter, first quarter, July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March, like that there will be 4 quarters, each quarter consists of 3 months. In the problem they will be very specific, they will say at the beginning of each quarter amount was withdrawn, uniform amount was withdrawn at the beginning of each quarter, or uniform amount at the end of each quarter, like that they will say, and we have to solve the problems. In the previous problem the partner used to draw uniform amount at the beginning of each month. Each month means 12 withdrawals. Here it is not like that, at the beginning of each quarter. So let us solve the problem on that. Murthy and Patil are partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. Murthy withdrew rupees 4000 quarterly at the beginning of each quarter. Interest on drawings at 9% per annum for the year ending 31st March 2017. Calculate interest on drawings. That is the problem. Murthy withdrew rupees 4000 quarterly at the beginning of each quarter. So let us see when the withdrawals were made. That is year ends on 31st March 2017. That means the year has started on 1st April 2016, 16, 17. So year ends on 31st March 2017. So the number of withdrawals, there will be 4 withdrawals at the beginning of each quarter. Means let me write the quarter here. First quarter will be, first one will be 1st April 2016 to 30th June 2016, that is 3 months gap. Then second quarter starts on 1st July 2016 and ends on 30th September 2016. Third quarter starts on 1st October 2016, ends on 31st December 2016, and last quarter starts on 1st January 2017 and ends on 31st March 2017. These are the 4 quarters. Now the partner withdrew, Murthy has drawn at the beginning of each quarter. That means the withdrawal was made on 1st April 2016, 1st July 2016, 1st October 2016 and 1st January 2017. These are the dates of withdrawal that we have to understand. This is given to understand in a better way. I have analyzed it in a different way. I made four quarters here so that if it is at the end of each quarter, in the same problem, suppose the problem is given like Murthy has withdrawn at the end of each quarter, then his withdrawal will be on, first withdrawal will be on 30th June 2016 and second withdrawal 30th September 2016, 31st December 2016 and 31st March 2017. These will be the four withdrawals if it is at the end of each quarter. Now in the problem, at the beginning of each quarter, so let us calculate interest on drawings now. Interest on drawings. Now see the format, follow the format, calculation of interest on drawings. They told us not under average period method, not shortcut method, under product method, it is very clearly mentioned. Under product method, we can calculate under average period method also by applying the formula, but as the method asked in the problem was product method, students must follow the product method. If you solve under average period method, you will get a big zero even though your answer is correct. Remember this. See the method asked in the problem and stick on to the question. Don't deviate from the question. Now let us solve the problem. Statement showing calculation of interest on drawings. Statement showing calculation of interest on drawings. Interest on drawings. Draw the columns. Product method, date, amount drawn, date of withdrawal, amount drawn, time period and product. Date of withdrawal, withdrawal, then amount drawn, time period and product. These are the columns. Yes. Now let us take up. Murthy withdraw rupees 4000 quarterly at the beginning of each quarter. That means first withdrawal of Murthy 4000 each. So write here 4000, date of withdrawal 4000, amount and date of withdrawal was on 1st April 2016 at the beginning of each quarter, first quarter beginning this is. Then time period, how much time is there from 1st April 2016 to end of accounting year 31st March 2017. So here there will be 12 months. Assign column numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is the product of 2 and 3. 2 into 3. So 12 months, you can write here for information, write in pencil, 1st April 2016 to 31st March 2017. This is the first withdrawal. So 12 fours are 48,000. Second one, on 1st July, beginning of second quarter, at the beginning of each quarter. So, 1st July 2016, 1st July 2016, same amount. This is from 1st July to end of the year, it will be 9 months. 9 months. That is 1st July 2016 to 30th September 2016. Second quarter. No, I'm sorry, 9 months, that will be 31st March, year end, 31st March 2017. 31st March 2017 it will be. So 2017, 9 months, so 9 fours are 36,000. Then 1st October 2016, third withdrawal, third quarter, 1st October 2016, amount is same, 4,000. Write the amount. That will be 1st October to 31st March of next year. It will be 6 months duration. 6 months. Write within bracket. 1st October 2016 to 31st March 2017. So 24,000. Then last one, 1st January 2017. 1st January 2017. So amount same, 4,000. That is 3 months duration. 3 months, that is from 1st January 2017 to 31st March 2017. 3 months, 12,000. Now write the total product. Total product. How much? So 4876, 100, 112,000. No, I think 120,000. Yes, it is 120,000. 120,000 is the total product. Total product. So now apply the formula. Interest on drawings is equal to total product into rate into one unit of time. So here we should make clear that total product, it is 120,000. Rate given in the problem, refer the rate given. I think it is 9%. Yes, it is 9%. 9 by 100 into, for how many months you will calculate? That is the question now. For how many months you will calculate? See, very simple, friends. That is 12 months, 9 months, 6 months, 3 months added together. 12 plus 9, 21, 27, 30. So total number of months, if you add together, it will be 30 months. So 30 divided by number of withdrawals. How many withdrawals are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So each quarter one withdrawal means there will be 4 withdrawals. So divide it by 4, you will get the number of months that is to be entered here. So 30 divided by 4 means 7.5 or 7.5 months. In the previous case, we took how many months? Only, that is for 1 month, 1 month duration. But here there are 4 withdrawals, so we divide it by 4, total number of months, and it is divided by 4, so it will be 7.5. right here 7.5, you will write it as 15 by 2 into 1 by 12. 7.5 month out of 12 months. Simplify it, you will get rupees 900. Right, last sentence. Therefore, interest on drawings of Mr. Murthy is rupees 900. Therefore, interest on drawings of Mr. Murthy is rupees 900. So that is how you have to calculate. We have calculated only for 7.5 months. We took average period, that is a period as time period as 15 by 2 or 7.5 months. And if there are 12 withdrawals at the beginning of each month, for how many months we have to calculate? That is very simple. Listen me carefully. 12, first withdrawal will be on 1st April, at the beginning of the accounting year, that is 12 months. 1st April to 31st March, it will be a duration of 12 months. So, second withdrawal will be on 1st May, then 1st June, 1st July, likewise. So, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you add it together, how much it will be? Add it together. So how many withdrawals are there at the beginning of each month? Means there are 12 withdrawals. If you count here, then there will be 12 withdrawals each month. Every month there is a withdrawal. So 12 months. So divide it by 78. 78 divided by 12 is equal to 6.5 or 6.5 months. Remember this. That is how we apply the number of months. In your reader, that is NCERT textbook, it is not clearly given how to calculate these months. They simply told calculate for 6.5 months, and if it is in the middle of the month, then calculate for 6 months, and if it is at the end of the month, then calculate for 5.5 months. How that 5.5 month, 6.5 month, 6 month has arrived, nowhere it is explained. So make sure, friends, number of withdrawals, there are 78. See, outstanding months, 12 11 10, if you add together, that will be 78. And number of withdrawals are 12, divide the total number of, that is months, by the number of withdrawals, you will get the average period. So here, whatever I have applied here, that is 15 by 2 or 7.5 months, it is because of that formula only. On that basis only, here there are 4 withdrawals and total number of months I have calculated, and I have shown it to you. 7.5 months, 30 are there. So 30 divided by 4 withdrawals, it will be 7.5 months. That is what I took here. So the amount of drawings, the interest on drawings is rupees 900. I will take up in the next class, that is at the beginning of each month and at the end of each month. This is the problem on quarterly withdrawals, 4 withdrawals in a year, but at the beginning of each month, end of each month means there will be 12 withdrawals. We'll solve a problem, that is fourth problem, in the next class. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.